Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Imrie and Henry Esports Broadcast. My name is Jay, and I'm joined by Jacob, a.k.a. Scoobert Dubert. You can check out, if you can see it.
Brand new jerseys.
Yep. They're very comfortable.
They are.
They look sick.
Got the big logo there.
Hornets, wasps, kind of, rather. Yeah, whatever.
Not wasps. Stingers. Gosh, I cannot speak.
Stingers up.
I literally said almost every animal that has a stinger before I just said stinger.
We are here again for the Smash Brothers broadcast.
Yep, and we would like to apologize for the delays. We had some trouble getting the match started, but luckily both teams are ready to go now, so...
Yeah, there are some technical difficulties on the other college's side, I believe.
Right,
but it seems
they said their TV stopped working, which is a really unfortunate timing for something like that.
Yeah, I mean, can't really do much about that, but
and
we're getting right
into
it.
The first match.
We're starting with Dylan on the Dr. Mario.
Up first. You guys might notice we're not using the usual name, what is it, Alex Swaggers? Ours is a mysterious number that, if you've been keeping up with esports, Imrie and Henry esports history, might ring a bell with our opponent. We'll let you figure that out.
And it seems like Dylan wants to recreate that moment in history as he's starting out here. And he's sort of just getting into his very classical style of play.
Wait, what just happened with that boomerang? Did he cape it backwards and it hit the I was trying to figure out what happened to boomerang still.
Wow.
A fast kill. It looks like 25 seconds in.
Yeah, no, that was basically instantaneous. Dylan gets the first stock with a cheeky down B on the corner of the map.
That's the benefits to knowing your kill ranges, because he knew an up B would kill there.
Yeah.
And so he went right for it.
And he's just going right back to that sort of pill spam, constantly poking away. Went for a little cheeky forward air there, or back forward air.
Back forward air. That's pretty impressive. I thought you could only do like one at a time.
Nah, not if you're Dylan.
So he's throwing out that cape every now and then just to try to keep it fresh on Link's mind, get him scared to use his projectiles.
Yeah.
Even when he did it a second ago and there wasn't even a projectile coming at him. Yeah, see right there.
Yeah.
Just to keep the Link on his toes.
Yeah. And I mean, you can tell that there's a sort of standoff here where Dr. Mario is in kill range and he's playing pretty safe as a result, but that up just runs up and up smashes him. The Link stops shielding for some reason, and another one!
He'll never predict the second one in a row, ever.
He just stood there for a second.
Good old up smash.
Went for the ground up B, didn't get there. And Dylan wants another one. Dylan's...
Oh boy, oh my gosh. Oh. Oh no, I thought... Okay, for some reason I was worried he died. That almost was a Luigi Zero to death. Dr. Mario.
Oh, goes for another one, and
knowing the kill ranges. Okay, not quite. The DI was pretty good, and that B happened a little lower that time on the stage. So
that was a nice bomb on the Toon Link's part to sort of get the cover to come on back to the stage. But this Toon Link has to be sweating at this point. I mean, Dylan's just been styling. Yeah, you can tell. You can look into the eyes. There it was.
He always turns around too, because the backside of the up smash for Dr. Mario is the stronger part,
right?
Similar to Luigi, and so he always is able to turn around and get it angled right.
Yeah. And it's tense.
Probably gonna kill there.
That does it.
Wow. So 3-0.
Just really technical. One. I mean.
Yeah.
You know, spamming the projectiles, keeping space, setting the pace with those capes, like you were talking about. You know, and getting that damage up until you get the up smash kill or the down B kill.
Right,
I mean,
yeah.
it was like a professor giving a symposium on how to play Dr. Mario, you know?
And that was a fast one, too. Well, really, the first part was fast. It really is an average length match, but it felt like so much was happening.
Oh, yeah.
Like, by really quick.
Yeah, I think it slowed down there at the end where Dylan was making sure not to lose a stock there at the end, keeping it tight, not letting the Toon Link get any sort of entrances or get an opportunity to set the pace. So now we wait for their next player.
And we did lose game audio just now, so hopefully that's not another tech issue.
Yeah.
So Okay, never. All right, never mind. I forgot. I was just totally forgetting that we were going to start muting it between matches so that it wasn't obnoxious.
Yeah.
You can hear all the little clicks and stuff of them selecting things. So, never mind. My bad. I'm the tech issue here.
Yeah, a walking tech issue. Yeah, so I'm excited to see who they have next. I don't remember who they played last time.
Yeah, I don't remember the Toon Link even, so I think we've already seen a new person. Now, I could just be completely misremembering because it's been, you know, months, literally, like you know, last spring when we played, they would have played this team before. But obviously, we're going to keep going strong with the Dr. Mario, Dylan. Yeah. I mean, I think...
Three.
Yeah, three right now. I mean, it says it at the bottom of the screen.
Yeah.
As well.
It does.
I do think that there's a little bit of an attempt at recreating history, like you said, because of the Dylan. I think that's why they ran Dylan up first.
Oh, yeah, normally we don't do it. No, normally we wait for Dylan to be the dead ringer at the back, you know, to finish strong in case he's needed. I think that there are other factors at play.
Ulterior motives here. So we're picking stage now, so we should be starting this next matchup soon.
D was an interesting stage pick. I think that might have... I don't know who had the first choice, but I think Toon Link would like FD. You know, there's not... You can kind of constantly spam projectiles, and there's not a lot of, like, space you can go to reliably get away from it. Now we're going to...
That's the new stage from Kingdom, Disney Guy.
Yeah, Sora. Oh, and...
Oh, wow.
The lore. Dang. My man just loves Kingdom Hearts.
Sora. I don't think you guys saw that yet, but yeah, the opposing team picked Sora on Sora's stage. That's pretty amazing.
Yeah. I want to believe that that's why we're here. It's nothing about strategy. It's just this is Sora's stage, dude.
I mean, if you know, I'm not at the level where strategy is always something I'm thinking about with stage selection. So like, that's what I would do. Personally.
Yeah. And now we get to see Sora do Sora things. Yeah, very annoying to play.
Really technical, you know, you have to side B three whole times. No, I'm just kidding. Sora definitely has some things that are hard to play about him. Like his floatiness is often a big disadvantage.
Oh, yeah.
And because of this.
Oh,
I mean,
my God, again.
Really, his air mobility is like, you could be fast with it with his abilities, but otherwise he's really easy to catch in the air.
Yeah, and now, I mean, that's literally exactly how the first stock went for Toon Link, and in about the same amount of time.
Yeah, it's about 30 seconds yet again. I mean, like... You know, Dylan is an incredible player, and I think he was really prepared for this team. I definitely heard him talking about it beforehand. They're scouting and all that kind of stuff. So, and you know Dylan, he's always in the lab. I mean,
oh yeah.
Last week, last week we lost.
And, to a Zelda. And,
to
in
a Zelda.
Particular.
And we walked out of this commentating booth into the other room.
Oh.
Up smash always. We walked into the other room. And Dylan was practicing
with that very same Zelda, yeah.
So we know he's in the lab always, and I'm sure he labbed out these matchups before.
Yeah. And, I mean, Sora's a weird character. It has options both at a range and up close with the side Bs. But it seems like Dylan's just kind of, you know, moving all around the Sora. Like, it's the amount of, like...
I always forget you can just spam
just
those.
Keep doing
like,
it yeah
it always catches me off guard when I'm playing against Sora because like when does it end
it doesn't
but yeah I mean well, like I
that's
didn't
it
tell what happened for a second but man Dylan busted on another really good match so Sora I feel like is probably a pretty good matchup for us because like I say he's pretty slow in the air and you know Dr. Mario really likes to combo a lot of combo potential with him as an opponent.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. You can really keep track of him easily. And like I said, he's really annoying when he gets going, Sora, where, just constantly bumping you around in the air. You don't really know what's going on. You have to wait for your turn forever. But Dylan didn't have that issue. He set the pace of the match and just with a really technical, clean performance. Got another three stock. That's six down there.
Yeah, that is a six. You could put it in front of our name and pretty
it'd
nice
be pretty
number.
Fun it'd be pretty epic.
It's one of the funny numbers.
It is one of the funny numbers, yeah.
But I mean nine might be I mean this is the match we'll know.
Yeah.
I mean this is the game we will know if nine happens again.
I kinda wanna see it happen, I'm not gonna lie.
I think it'd be even more dramatic if we got eight And then next round we got nine.
Ooh. Yeah, I don't like that. I mean, I do like that idea.
But yeah, I mean, like you said, we're up against Ness, which is probably pretty annoying against
I wouldn't want to.
Mario.
Yo, I like the yo.
Yeah, I do. It feels like Ness would say, yo.
Yo. And yeah, if I remember correctly, their nest was, if this is the same nest,
I'm pretty sure they were pretty good.
they were good. Yeah, and you can see right now they're doing stuff.
Oh,
Ooh,
a
love to
little bit
see
of
it.
lag. That's it. Hopefully, that's just one little spike for us. Oh,
Oh, it
they
seems like
thinking
they're.
about resetting, maybe. No, all right, no,
Oh,
they are not.
oh my!
Oh no! Oh
Same
no! Twenty
three
six point
times.
nine, nice percent. That's it. Like that's all the damage Ness got on him.
Three times in a row, the exact same
Yep.
kill method.
In about 25 seconds each time.
Yeah, that's absolutely incredible. And now, I mean, you can feel the lag, but it seems like at the very least we're.
Oh, he still teched the.
Oh
Oh no!
no!
Is that what happened, or did he just
No,
bounce?
I think he just bounced
Okay.
wrong. You hate to see that sort of thing. You always want to have like a proper match, you know, without any major mistakes like that. But still, I mean, there's one stock left, and.
Right.
Man, I'm excited to see if we get the nine stock.
Right. Yeah. I mean, we're one away right now. Like,
Yeah.
and we're turning to history. History does tend to repeat
It
itself, as you
does.
say.
Oh.
Yep. And that's nine.
That's
We have
nine.
reached nine. Sorry, I'm answering your question in my. The esports director had for us, so sorry I was distracted for a moment. But
I
that
don't
is
mean to
nine.
let the silence hang, but I was reeling. I was reeling. Just absolutely vicious. That's the only word that can describe what we just
Yeah.
witnessed. A vicious takedown.
Does vicious have nine letters in it? It does not.
Oh, damn. But yeah, just, you know, great showing on the part of
It says I'm typing. Oh, I'm not. All right, all right.
great showing on the part of Dylan.
What are you, Dylan?
Just Dylan. We didn't
Yeah.
see any other players.
Which, you know, is sad, but I'm glad it happened.
I am
You know,
too.
maybe
No, that's a worthy
hopefully
sacrifice.
we'll have, now that we've returned to nine, hopefully we'll have some we'll maybe let's save Dylan for last for
Yeah.
this next one.
Unless
Unless we want to go for 18.
18. 18. Who knows?
I mean, I don't know. I'm of two minds. Like,
Yeah.
I want to see 18, but I'm also like, I want to see
I
our
want to see some Dr. Mario, damn it. Yeah. Yeah, we'll see. We'll see. But I mean, what can you say really? That was just classic Dylan.
Yep.
Super tight play. Like I've said this before, there's never an input that doesn't need to be made. Like,
Exactly.
and he's always making inputs, like whether it's creating pressure with pills or just using the right air attack. Like it's always on point. I wouldn't want to play against him
Yeah, I mean, like
in a
I feel like
circumstance.
Dylan also has this level of elevation when he gets locked in. I mean, we've seen him play a little more, like, well, I guess not. I guess I wouldn't say we've seen him play sloppier, but we have seen him play even tighter. And
Yeah.
this is one of those times. I mean, I think he was really motivated by
Yeah.
the history of this match
Yeah.
and wanted to do that again. And you
Right.
know, it's also the same case as whenever he gets pissed off.
Right.
Dylan, he is the opposite of tilt. I mean,
Yeah, no,
like,
he
I've never
locks
seen it
in.
on another player before.
Yeah. No, it's you know, some competitors have that sort of
Oh,
energy
for
where if
sure.
they get upset, that's what feeds them, you know.
Yeah, I mean, you definitely see it a lot more in like physical sports than you do
Yeah,
esports, I
like
feel.
Jordan, you know, or
Yeah, and a lot of boxers too.
right.
But man, Dylan definitely has that about him, and I love it. It does look like we are going to see some of our other players
Yeah.
for this one because we're switching off of our names. So we're going to see Jared on the Wii Fit trainer.
And I do love the Wii Fit trainer. I love a weird character, you know, sort of has all these little strange gimmicks, which are fun.
Yeah.
And I think I said this last broadcast, she's always been a character that's strong, but has always sort of like hovered just beneath the
Yeah,
very
right, the
upper
cusp
echelons of,
tier one.
yeah. But in the hands of a capable player, I mean, she can really,
Right,
you
yeah.
know.
I mean, and she's kind of like I like her because she is viewed as a legit character, But she plays like Game and Watch.
Yeah, you know? Yeah, right. I mean, you have the weird charge thing. You have like the ground. You have all these funny like angled normals. It's great.
Alrighty, so here we go. Starting round two on Wii Fit against Toon Link yet again. They went with the same starting player.
And this time we are on, I believe this is Town and City.
Now, it's one of the Animal Crossing ones.
Yeah.
Don't draw attention to the fact that we're not saying the specific name.
I said it and I might be wrong.
No, I think this is Town and City though. I believe you're correct. But either way, starting a lot of harass.
This is going to be a projectile matchup. Yeah.
The way that Jared likes to play Wii Fit.
Yeah.
You know, it's very projectile heavy. Like we were saying last week, she's pretty versatile. You can play her a variety of ways.
Right.
Jared does like prefer the projectile game, so.
Yeah, sort of, you know, get that enhanced normal and create space with the with all the projectiles, praise the sun, etc., and then, you know, use it.
Yeah,
like
soccer
that.
Ball right to the yeah. face. And you know, like I was gonna say a second ago when we were behind on percentage, Wii Fit where she can heal herself. Jared likes to use it very often. It's sometimes the percentage lead is not as big as it might seem because of how often Jared likes to use that heal.
Yeah.
Of course, we haven't seen it here in a second. He's at 90% now.
Oh,
nice. I did not think that was gonna be able to hit.
That was a clean punishment. Like, cause I think that he was just outside of the range of it.
Yeah.
I was kind of afraid that.
We got hit. No, we didn't. We were at 90%. It really. I thought we got hit.
So no, we didn't.
Animation, like, was weird.
That was a pixel off. Yeah. It was really close.
I thought even Wii Fit had got knocked back, but apparently I was just mad.
Oh, clean little projectile falling off the stage to have it have a sort
oh,
of...
Oh, there we go. The dash attack. I was just wondering when we... Oh, no, the defense. I was just wondering when Wii Fit would be, looking for the kill, because 146 is pretty high to just still be using soccer balls and stuff.
Yeah, you're at a point where the dash attack is enough to get the kill in. Again, using that sort of off the stage soccer ball, and that's immaculate DI.
Really not kill.
Yeah.
Even with good DI, that's because we were at over 100%.
Yeah.
Oh, probably could have punished there. Missed a little bit of an opportunity, but. Oh.
And you can see now the shield's looking rough. Gets the grab off to punish the sort of reliance on the shield. Really conditioning the Toon Link here.
Yeah, I think the Toon Link is starting to get a little frustrated because they're... Okay, never mind. Approach was really clean. They didn't follow it up right, but the approach was clean.
Yeah.
At first I was going to say thinking they were frustrated because their approaches were getting sloppy, but... Now they're dodging and
sort
really
of
well.
Yeah, the high jump there probably wasn't ideal, but gets a nice in.
That Toon Link can block with a shield.
Here, yeah,
he just remembered, and I think he's gonna start doing that a little bit more.
Yeah, hopefully. Well, I mean, you know, we want to win, but I'm kind of, you know, I want to see the Toon Link, you know, play.
We don't want to see competition.
Yeah, yeah.
This is like, we think could die any minute. Get a lot of percentage though for this stock.
Yeah.
It's really you don't want to see that as, on your opponent whenever you're approaching the same percentage but they're still on their first stock.
Yeah. Like that's definitely rough, and the Toon Link's having a really hard time finding a way. Ooh, will that kill? It will.
Oh, wow. So we got two stocks before we've lost our first one.
Yeah, we're on 159, and this Toon Link just can't find a way to finish the stock off. Tries for the, I think that was an up B on stage.
I think they just aren't using their Link's, like, I don't know, passive shield thing enough. I mean,
yeah, that could help.
One ability, and I think it was on accident because they were trying to parry.
Right. Yeah, this is, it's not looking great for Sloth Siege's first player.
We don't know exactly which player is which on their team, so.
Yeah. But, I started saying his name, and then I was like, or their name, and then I realized, like,
they're playing for Wake Forest, by the way.
Wake Forest,
I did say that, but just it's a reminder for any viewers just tuning in. And that's going to be a kill for sure. So we do lose one stock on this, but hopefully that'll be the only one. I mean, Toon Link's at 125, so
I suspect it is. One gentleman into a smash attack, or just about anything at this point that isn't a projectile should get the sock here.
Yeah, I think Jared needs to start getting a, I mean, I think maybe he's just wanting to get a kill with a soccer ball, but I think he needs to start playing a little more aggro. Okay, yeah, I think he just wanted to do that.
Yeah.
Because he literally stood still.
Yeah, like, no, that seemed like a bit of a victory lap.
Oh, boy.
And that's game one out of the way.
I'm just now looking at our chat where we like to put our match history, and the first match is just got Dylan posted. And Nathan goes like, he just now realized what happened.
Yeah.
Oh man, sorry, that's funny. Yeah. So anyways, 2-1 or 3-1, sorry, on our first round. Only lost a single stock is
yeah.
Really good start. I mean, you'll have to see that our, you know, like we were saying in I think first or second week, our you know, non-Dylan players have really been putting in the work and
oh,
practice
yeah.
And
oh yeah.
They're competing a lot harder and so I'll be able to take a lot of pressure off Dylan, so.
Oh yeah, it's definitely got to be a bit of a weight off of Dylan's shoulder, as well as like being sort of reassuring for the other players to, you know, have a more direct contribution in the outcome of these matches.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, you know, anybody will tell you team sports, and you know, I know this is a kind of a team sport, but it still is.
Yeah.
They're all about like you say, making you feel like you're contributing something.
Yeah.
If you feel like you're left out, then your morale is going to go down, and you're going to drag the team down with you.
Right.
So, props to the Smash team for you know, always keeping a great, like, seem to keep a level head and.
Yeah,
like,
good spirits. Well. Yeah. We're going back to Hollow Bastion, and I think that means we got that Sora lore pick.
I would imagine that is the Sora. Though, of course, we did just stay on it for round three last time.
Oh, no, the Crom.
Google Crom. In here.
Okay.
Soon, Crom is not going to be able to use ad blockers anymore. I don't know if you've read about that or not.
That's pretty upsetting. I'm not going to lie.
He will not be able to use a shield in Smash.
No. Well, I mean...
Blocker.
this guy just started. Oh, no.
It's okay. I imagine we're just going to proceed as normal. Bro. Okay. Hold on, Crom.
I guess we're just doing okay. It.
Alrighty. Well... well, anyway, with the weird match start out of the way,
yeah,
we're getting going now.
Crom just really wants to play, man.
Yeah, to be clear to anybody who's not familiar with the rules, are we fit losing, having lost the stock in the first round, had to SD once, and
yes.
Then they had to return to a neutral state, like basically spawn position, and taunted each other to
yeah.
signify the actual start of the match. But
yep.
Crom got a little eager.
Crom's an eager beaver, wanted to go, but it looks like we're into the thick of it now, and... Crom's getting some good damage in. Not to pick on this guy, but there's an example of the opposite of what I'm talking about with Dylan, where he was kind of using like an up B there for basically no reason. There was no purpose to that input. And that's really a hard thing to get out of the habit of, especially in a game like Smash,
yeah,
where you just want to press buttons.
It's really, yeah. I mean, it's, you know, kind of branded as a party game, and most people's first interactions with it are as a party game. And so sometimes it can be hard to break out of that mentality.
Yeah.
And it's also just a fast game anyway.
Yeah, exactly.
On top of that. Ooh, nice.
Ooh.
Oh, man, what a punish. What a dodge into the punish.
Jared's timing on these, like, sort of specials.
Yeah.
Like, same with the Toon Link. That's incredible.
Yeah, and he's doing what I said he should be doing in this match more, which I think confirms my theory about him just wanting to get projectile kills.
Yeah.
Where he's actually running in with his opponents at higher percentage and actually going for you know, kills.
Yeah. And there should
how
be a punish
about,
there. Oh, just short. Yeah, how about this?
I think that's what comes up.
I believe you're right. That's Matthew Mercer on the voice, I happen to know.
I actually didn't know that.
Yeah.
But, you know, I should have figured, because he's literally every character in every game.
Yes.
So.
But, yeah, you can see how, I mentioned this in the last round, that Jared really conditions with the projectiles, tries to get the opponent in the habit of shielding, and then goes in for the grab and sort of changes.
And you can kind of tell that that Dylan is the leader.
Nice.
Nice.
Oh,
no, I didn't think that
if
was
he hadn't
go,
jumped there,
actually.
I think
yeah,
he would have
so.
Lived.
But you can tell that Dylan is kind of the top player in the Emery Dojo, because like Dylan plays, or Jared plays just like him. You know,
right.
Like with the big ship, it's soccer balls instead of
yeah.
Balls.
Yeah, it's like heavier zoning because the zoning abilities are stronger. But yeah, no, it's the same sort of like, you know, condition with the pills, create a really oppressive atmosphere, and then execute once you get that conditioning out of the way. Nice tilt.
Dodged into it. That was a really good read from the Crom there.
Oh,
wow. 78%.
That's crazy.
Oh my god.
That's absolutely insane. And also, what a zoom in. That's another reason I love Wii Fit. It's just so funny. The yoga pose is getting broken out.
Literally all of her attacks. Yoga poses or, like, you know, exercise equipment.
Right.
Or hula hoops. I guess it's an exercise equipment, but still.
Yeah. But yeah, very well done again by Jared there. I mean, just a super strong showing. And now we're going to the final player on the opponent.
And we're still on our first player for hours.
That's true.
So we might get 18 a different way.
Yeah, that's true.
We are on 15.
Yeah, yeah.
I think that only goes away if we lose a full game, if I recall correctly.
I think you're right.
So we might get 18 still.
Yeah, one could say that in this case, at the very least, Jared has lost 2 stocks so far.
Yes.
So he's on the edge. All it takes is one more. And
we
then...
never said 9-0. We said
9. 9.
9-2 still starts with a 9.
That's true. That's true.
Yeah, Jared is, wow. I mean, I think this is by far his best match we've seen out of him this season.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
You know, not to disc. I mean, he's been playing great, so that's an incredible feat.
Yeah.
To outperform a really good performance.
The timing on those punishes on the specials in both his first and second round were really, really
for
good.
Sure. You could tell there must have been a big focus on their practices lately.
Yeah, punishing unsafe startups,
right,
and finishers.
Because
yeah,
that's really what he's been doing a lot of in both of these rounds. So
yeah,
I wonder if that Chrom player was their Sora, or if we'll be seeing the Sora now.
Based on the playstyle, I kind of felt like that was the Sora. And
the mid-stage selection, because I'm pretty sure that was their stage.
Yeah, play. Yeah. And the Ness plays a lot more like sort of like always on, I think, as opposed to the Chrom.
I doubt they want to switch off of Ness as well.
Yeah.
There we go. There's the Ness.
Yeah,
so.
Their Ness was nice. So I'm interested to see how Jared does with the Ness, because it's an annoying matchup no matter who you are. But unlike Dr. Mario, Weefa Trainer can match the projectile spin.
That's true, but Ness also has ways
the absorber.
to absorb him. I can't ever remember. It's Villager's pocket.
Villager has the pocket. Ness and Lucas have the absorption, so.
Oh, they look so similar. I always get them mixed up.
Yeah, they're just little dudes.
Alrighty, and here we go. 1 stock on our Wii Fit Trainer, so pretty unlikely, but I'm really rooting for the...
Oh yeah, me too. And
so
nice start.
That's a grab punish on an approach. That's pretty good.
Yeah, you can tell that this Ness is like, alright, I'm gonna get...
Oh, nice. Oh, okay.
Oh, no!
Okay, not dead, but man, I think if they had hit at a slightly different angle, that would have killed off the top.
That was so stylish.
That was crazy good combo. I loved it. I thought he was just going to spam up air.
Yeah.
No, he did the really cool play. I loved it.
Yeah, that was really sick. Nice escape from the PK fire. That's a big thing. Good grab into the soccer ball, well positioned.
Okay.
There he gets the absorption.
He was already absorbing before he shot the exile, but hey,
probably
sometimes it's to break habits.
Yeah, but that was really... The Ness is matching this pace really well, and that might be the stock. Oh, he just survives. Doesn't go for the yo-yo. Ness has the yo-yo, right? Or is it just Lucas?
I actually don't remember.
It might only be Lucas. But either way, this is a really oppressive edge
man.
Guard.
Yeah, this is a very hard recovery.
Oh,
okay.
Goes for the...
They're always really helpful for that.
Yeah, I think the Ness was going for the Nair there. Nice.
Grab mid-attack? Is
Yeah, these grabs are so bold.
Yeah,
oh,
he's been getting some really good ones with it. He's been reading these approaches really well.
Yeah.
He's trying to play off the stage a little bit to play safe.
Yeah.
I really like that.
There's a absorption, and I mean...
He's projectile.
Yep.
Can he not absorb the... He's not trying to absorb the soccer ball, is he?
Yeah, the soccer ball might have different properties as, like, an item.
Oh,
that's it. That back air seals the deal. But yeah, it might have the properties of, like, an item.
Yeah,
so.
Well, I know that the absorb is, like... I mean, like a lot of things in Smash, they can be very finicky. And I think it's, like, has to be, like, an energy-based thing or
that
something
might be
weird
it.
Like
yeah,
that.
That
I don't
might
know.
Be it, because that's the same with Game & Watch. It's, like, a reflector... when he pulls out the bucket, except for certain moves, which absorb.
So,
yeah.
That's probably what it is. At least we're not in the days where, like, Donkey Kong can punch around somebody because of the 3D space. Do you remember? Have you ever seen that?
Yeah, it's the Tekken, like...
Yeah, it's the Tekken, except it's not supposed to be. by the way, if you want to use these sick emotes of Sonic in our chat right now, subscribe over on
Mag2Easy.
Yes. That's Mag Too Easy Pop Sonic.
That's really cute.
You get it?
Yeah.
And then Mag Too Easy Happy Sonic because it's Sonic.
He's happy. He's so happy. I
like
that Pop Sonic a lot.
I do like
that's
Pop
really
Sonic.
Adorable.
I don't know where that's from. I wonder if he got somebody to make that for him.
Yeah.
I'm actually not
sure. Really good.
He's also got, I can't click on it, but he's also got the poorly drawn Sonic.
Oh, nice. That's sick. So yeah, go subscribe to Mac Too Easy.
Yeah, Mac Too Easy is a really cool gaming music.
Yeah,
show.
Reviews music.
Yeah.
I haven't been on it yet.
As in,
yet,
like,
the show where
not,
he talks to the music.
But you've not been, like, in it. Not, like, you just not... I thought you meant you haven't watched it. And
oh, no,
like,
I've watched
like,
it.
Like, bro,
no, I've watched
this a lot. Anyways,
yeah,
back to
anyway.
The match at hand. We are getting to see
in
Game
Cinema.
& Watch. We were just talking...
No, sorry.
The Incineroar is our profile icon.
I was, like, shocked. Because
wait, Cole can't play.
yeah.
We were getting to see Game & Watch. We were just talking about how We Fit and Game & Watch have a pretty similar playstyle despite being viewed very differently by the community.
Right.
Which is, you know, I think very funny because I hate playing against both of them.
Oh yeah. No, I mean I honestly prefer Game & Watch over We Fit.
To play as or against?
Against.
I
feel like that might not be a popular opinion, but
You prefer to play against Game & Watch?
Yes.
Yeah, no, I don't. I would rather play against We Fit.
Yeah, I think most people. I don't know what it is. Maybe, like, I don't really understand.
For my own, like, thing that I've pointed out of being her being viewed different. I mean, I don't have a, like, specific reason.
Well, I don't understand We Fit very well. I do understand Game & Watch. Like,
okay, well, yeah, that definitely.
Like, all of the attacks of We Fit are, like, really weird, and so are Game & Watches. So, I mean,
yeah,
look at this.
Say,
look at this.
It's like, if that's your argument, that's a bad argument.
But I know those attacks well, so I'm chilling, you know? Oh, nice down smash, by the way.
Yeah, so I, you know, it'll be fun to see how this game, the Game & Watch plays this match.
There, the bucket.
The fact that he just stood there. Yeah.
Oh,
really
the classic down smash into sides.
He is at 87% while Game & Watch is at 1%.
Yeah,
this is
nasty.
This is going pretty rough right now.
Oh, goes for the impressive. Oh no! I like
really
it.
Like when he's playing.
Yeah.
Where he's just walking up and standing still with a move.
Yeah.
It's such a Chad.
It's yeah. It's very imposing. Like you don't. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. This is. I mean, this is such a wacky match.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, okay. Wow.
That was just
a forward chair,
tilt.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess we should have known this would be wacky because of the. Oh no.
Oh okay.
Whoa, that was.
I don't really know. Why he was able to up B again?
Yeah, maybe he got tapped by the lightning.
Yeah, I'm guessing that might be it.
Maybe it was at low enough percent that it didn't really knock him around anywhere. That's
yeah.
weird. I'm not really sure what happened.
Yeah, I'm glad it wasn't just me. Oh,
oh
no.
Bucket.
He's got
it
the bucket.
Like it was too far away to have bucketed.
Oh,
to
the
me.
Bucket's a generous god.
Apparently.
He doesn't have enough to spill the bucket, but he does. He needs one more projectile. I love Game & Watch, dude. I love him so
yeah,
much.
I was just laughing. You were just commentating legitimately.
Yeah.
It was funny.
Yeah. A nice grab. And
he's going,
yeah,
he's
you can
still
see.
Trying to get that last bit on the bucket.
He wants
really
the bucket
wants
kill.
To kill with it,
yeah.
Which, you know, reasonable. I feel like that's one of the main reasons you picked Game &
yeah.
Watch. Because you like the fight. Still trying to get it.
Well, you know what he's trying to do? He's trying to get stuff the recovery. He wants.
That's probably.
He wants Ness to up.
Thing, yeah.
No, but I mean, it'd be so funny if Ness up bees and he just jumps in and gets the bucket. And
it wouldn't it be great if Ness hit himself with the lightning and then he fell into the bucket?
Yeah,
he
just a little.
Does have a full bucket now? By the way, I'm
that
gonna
is
add.
True.
He's probably.
Oh. Gonna
say he's probably gonna save it for the third stock, but I don't think he has to. I mean, he gets to, but I don't even think he needed to plan on it.
By the way, we did see the yo-yo, so Ness does it. Oh my!
Oh yes! The payoff! All match we were talking about.
The Chekhov's bucket, baby! Let's go!
And that is almost 18 for us. I mean, it's so close to an 18.
Or 16.
Well, I guess it still says 18 on the screen, so I'm going to count it as.
Alright, hey, we got.
Either way, we lost, what, three stocks the entire night? Or
yes.
did Game & Watch?
No.
We lost three stocks the entire night.
A dominating
not
performance.
Not round two. The entire game.
Yeah.
Like
no, that was a dominating performance by our boys. Loved the game. Everybody we saw played immaculately.
Yeah,
you know?
All two. Well, no,
three.
We didn't see three. Yeah,
we
sorry.
Didn't see Dempsey. but yeah, that was great. Just super solid performance all around.
Right.
The Game & Watch was hilarious and really well played. We Fit was doing We Fit stuff, you know, really impressive and excellent use of projectiles with some really sick, you know, interruptions on special moves. And of course, Dylan, you know, with his, you know, nine stock run.
Yeah. And
was...
speaking of Dylan, like we were saying, Our non-Dylan players have been really picking up the pace. We didn't even see them set round two.
Yeah, exactly. Right. Yeah, no, that was just Jared and Dempsey. And was
I think that's Dempsey. Let's see. That was Alex. Sorry, Alex. Game Watch. My bad.
Yeah.
So yeah, I mean, we didn't even have to release the beast.
Nah. Hey, that's we got a team full of beasts now, you know, and yeah. You love to see it. But everybody. Yeah, thank you for tuning in, and we will be here.
We should be here next Monday for this, and then throughout the week we've got
Valorant,
Overwatch 2, which we played. We finally got to start Overwatch 2 season 1, our first match of it.
Excellent.
That's our inaugural Overwatch 2 season. Now think about it. So heck yeah, I was like, we've had Overwatch before, but no,
this is Overwatch 2. It's
our first win in Overwatch 2.
It's a new game. Wink, wink.
Yeah, it's not. It's definitely not Overwatch like 2.0, like an update. It's a new game, obviously. But anyways, well, and then Friday, hopefully, we'll have League of Legends. We had to reschedule this past one, so we can get to stream it. It's supposed to be. I mean, that's our typical time for it.
Okay, cool.
We don't get to even know who our opponents are until Wednesday. So,
oh wow, yeah.
2 days before the match.
So it's all to say we've got a lot coming up. So feel free to tune in, and thank you all for watching. And we will be back soon.
Yep. Have a great night.
Yeah. Bye.